pennies or should I do it first? After that, yeah.
Thank you. gentlemen, I present to you your ASB president, Mr. Brandon Caputo.
Good afternoon, Mr. Curtis, distinguished guests, faculty, and students. Welcome to the 33rd annual Hands Across Campus, a day we honor and remember Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and his dream. A day we can celebrate, learn, and appreciate the many diverse cultures not only at Torrance High School, but everywhere in the nation. An acceptance of race and culture that was once a dream. 60 years ago, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. gave his I Have a Dream speech. A speech so powerful that it is still very much impactful and meaningful today. A dream that everyone be treated equal and free, regardless of the color of their skin. During that time, Dr. Martin Luther King gave this speech, the country was witnessing injustice, discrimination, segregation, and police brutality, all on judgments based off skin color. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. witnessed and said, "People fail to get along because they fear each other. They fear each other because they don't know each other. They don't know each other because they don't communicate with each other." He had a dream that everyone would get to know each other deeper than appearance and skin color, but to get to know each other's character. At Torrance High School, we pride ourselves on our diversity, inclusion, and our kindness to one another. At Torrance High, we fulfilled Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream. We have a multitude of culture clubs that openly extend membership to all students, regardless of race, and enthusiastically teach and share their culture. We see diverse friend groups, sports teams, and special interest clubs, all ensuring that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream is being fulfilled. But we cannot stop here. We must all continue to work, even beyond our days of being a target, to ensure that his dream becomes fully realized. For he said, "We are not satisfied, and we will not be satisfied until justice rolls down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream." So, we sit here today with the opportunity to get closer and closer to completely fulfilling his dream. The opportunity to communicate with one another and learn about each other's characters and to accept our differences, see past skin color, and to take the opportunity to embrace, appreciate, and learn about different cultures in a loving, enthusiastic way. A way that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. always dreamed about.
Thank you, Mr. President. Next, to perform, your Latino.
Thank you. Because we're all back in the start.
like to bring to the floor your Japanese cultural club.
Simulator, you're a safe. Get in the corner, it's a high. Good afternoon. As I stand here and look through the audience, I see people of all races, creeds, and color. At first glance, we seemingly achieve Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s journey of everyone sitting amongst one another in peace, not judging or curating preconceived notions based on the color of who is sitting next to us. But the Reverend's dream exceeds beyond. It exceeds to the service, love, and brotherhood we pour into uplifting our own culture along with others. Despite the differences in our skills, talents, or even hair texture, the one thing we all have in common is an opportunity to be significant. A quote that resonates within my spirit by the Reverend is when he uttered the thought, "Life's most persistent and urgent question is what are you doing for others?" This quote still stands today in 2022. What am I willing to do to help my fellow mankind? Because as we know, life is not the same for everyone, and not everyone is fortunate enough. There are people that have everything they need to live a quality life, and on the other hand, there are people that have to beg for every little thing they need to survive. One of the highlights of my life has been being a student here at Torrance High, where there's not a day that goes by that I sit in the classroom without a very diverse educator, student, or fellow charter that I walk the hallways with. Regardless of the color of their skin, I've made a lot of friends here at Torrance High. And the one thing that keeps us all together is the love and respect we have for one another. That, to me, is the essence of what Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. had in mind. Moreover, we live in a world where everyone wants to be famous. However, it's more important to be significant. Because being significant is determined by service, service to one another. Such as the servants of culture clubs on campus, having a great impact on its members, creating environments to find commonalities and experiences and struggles, but upholding a greater impact into shaping the community of Torrance High. Because it's here, out of the 30 schools in the Torrance Unified School District, that Torrance High has developed, implemented, and expanded on the 33-year-long tradition of hands across campus. Providing an outlet to give limelight to cultures that have been historically oppressed and underrepresented. As I end, I have the beginning in mind. What will be your contribution? This student body has the next set of doctors, teachers, police officers, professional athletes, and great thinkers. So, what will your significant service be? How are you helping mankind? We all get to decide. With that being said, it's my pleasure to introduce the I Have a Dream leaders.
Every hill and mountain shall be made low,
The rough places will be made plain,
and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together.
This is our hope. This is the faith with which I return to the sun. With this faith, we will be able to hew out the mountain of despair, a stone of hope.
With this faith, we will be able to transform the genuine discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
With this faith, we will be able to work together,
to pray together,
to struggle together,
to go to jail together,
to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day.
This will be the day where all of God's children will be able to sing with a new meaning. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing.
Land where my fathers died, land of the blood with pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring.
And if America should be a great nation, this must become true. So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire.
Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York.
Let freedom ring from the highly Alleghenies of Pennsylvania.
Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado.
California, but not only that, let freedom ring from the Stone Mountains of Georgia.
Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountains of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and every molehill of Mississippi. From every mountainside,
let freedom ring.
When we let freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up the day when all God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we're free at last."
Ladies and gentlemen, again, Mr. Robert Walker and your I Have a Dream greeter. Liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
The United States was a country founded on slavery, and one which 100 years after slavery's official dissolution remained half equal and half free. The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was a pacifist, a Baptist minister, a spiritual man, with a dream to eradicate injustice, and a brilliant tactician with a plan to make that dream come true. Dr. King commanded respect and attention for the civil rights movement, whose time was long overdue. He rallied support for the cause through masterful oratory and personal charisma, but mostly he did it by his shining example. He absorbed physical beatings, jail terms, scathing criticism from enemies and supporters alike, without ever veering from his path. This was a path that led him to Memphis, Tennessee, where he journeyed in April 1968 to lend support for a strike by local sanitation workers. It was there, standing on the balcony outside his room at the Lorraine Motel in the dimming sunlight, that afternoon, the 39-year-old Nobel Peace Prize winner made one final sacrifice for his cause.
Night. And then I got into Memphis. And some began to say the threats. I talk about the threats that were out. Or what would happen to me from some old our sick white brothers. Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now. Because I've been to the mountaintop. And I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over, and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. My eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
We honor this man today and his vast accomplishments and reflect upon the impact he's had on our lives. His dream that we've just heard spoke of change, spoke of hope, spoke of a future for America. Because of this man, America is a better place. Because of this man, I'm able to stand here, look out at our student body, and see all of the different faces and cultures united, unified as one. Because of this man, I'm able to work at a school with such a diverse population and witness you, the students, thrive together in pursuit of education. Because of this man, my mother, a Jamaican immigrant in the 60s, was able to preserve her dreams and become an American citizen. Because of this man, I'm able to find unconditional love with my wife, regardless of the color of our skin. And my son Jack to be able to pursue college degrees at the schools of their choice and know they will be judged not by the color of their skin but by the content of their character. Each year on the third Monday of January, schools, federal offices, post offices, and banks across America close as we celebrate the birth, the life, and the dream of Dr. Martin Luther King. It's a time for the nation to remember the injustices that Dr. King fought. Time to remember his fight for the freedom, equality, and dignity of all races and peoples. This is a time to remember his dream. It's at this time I ask all of you to rise.
What's your
feel the energy within the room, across the gym, as we listen to our Torrance High Troubadours with their rendition of Amazing Grace.
Thank you all.